Sean Zatel, BoxingVoice.com here with the Money Team's undefeated Kevin Newman. Kevin, what's going on?
What's going on, man? How you doing?
Doing great, man. I wanted you to, because you always do it so great for me, man. Please break down Kovalev War 2. Break it down.
Obviously, I got Ward winning that fight. You know, I like Ward. I like his skills. You know, Kovalev has great skills, too. I see this fight picking off from, like, you know, round 12, man, of the last fight, you know, and I think, you know, Kovalev's going to come out with that fight, you know, because I think he feels like he was done wrong, you know, and he's going to come out with that fight, but I think that they're going to clash, you know, and Ward's going to come out like, okay, you think you won, I'm going to show you. So I think it's going to be, you know, it's going to have a lot of fireworks in that fight, man.
It's interesting you say a clash, because can't that actually work out bad for either man? Ward taking too many chances, Kovalev too anxious to get his man out of there walking into stuff. What do you think about that?
I mean, I think for Ward to, you know, beat this guy decisively, he's going to have to take chances. And I think he's willing to take those chances. A lot of guys aren't willing to take those type of risks, you know. And that just shows, like, even in the fight when he got dropped, you know, he took him around to recover after that. But he came out and he was bringing the fight to Kovalev. So I think he's going to start off strong early, man, you know. And, you know, I think – see, the difference between Kovalev and Ward is Ward has the ability to adjust from what it seems like. It seems like Kovalev has that Russian amateur based style where that's like he only fights that one way. He don't know how to fight.
He's really good, but he can't do much else.
Great, he does it great. I mean, obviously he's got to the top somehow, you know. And but I feel like, you know, Ward has the ability to adjust. He's an American fighter. You know, they come here for the best work is in America. You know, so Ward can box. He can fight on the inside. You know, he can fight on the back foot. He can fight going forward. And I think that's going to play in his favor. I think Kovalev only knows how to fight going one way. You know, I mean, which is, you know, his basic European, you know, European style of boxing, man.
Ward going to have to get up off the canvas again to win this fight?
I don't think so. I think that he took Kovalev's best punch. And if you remember in the fight, after the fight, he still got hit flush a couple times clean. And he wasn't fazed by it. I think he got that one out the way, you know.
And he did kind of shut the right hand down. He was getting hit with the jab, but Kovalev was never able to land that shot again. That's the credit.
He didn't land that exact shot, but he landed the right hand a couple times even afterwards. And Ward took it. He took it, you know. So I think it's a mental thing. He's got that out the way. Like, okay, I see what his power feels like. Okay, I've been there, done that. And now the question is, we're going to see if Kovalev can take what Ward is dishing out this time. Because I look at Ward and I was watching some of his training stuff in the 24/7 thing. And I think dude is, you know, mentally, he's taking himself to another level. You know, I think he wants that action. You know what I'm saying? And I think that can work for him. You know, no risk, no reward. You know,
it's funny you say that. You keep bringing up that risk reward. And it's funny because when I talked to Andre over the weekend in the Bay, he said, I asked him, do you have the best defense in boxing? He goes, no, because I get hit because I'm actually trying to get something. I'm not.
It's easy. It's easy when you have good defense. You know, me being myself, you know, I have, you know, solid defense. You know, it's easy to play defense, you know, but you got to step out your comfort zone and take the fight to two guys, you know, and Ward has the ability to do that, you know. And I think that, you know, if you see, like, in the Edwin Rodriguez fight, you know, he took the fight to him. In the Chad Dawson fight, he took the fight to him. Obviously, Kovalev is not these guys. He's much more better than these guys are, you know. But Ward has the mentality, you know. He works like a dog. You know, he has the mentality to take it to Kovalev and go and dog him out.
You talk about some of the courage and confidence it takes to not just slip shots, but to stay in punching range while you slip so that you can get your own off after you miss.
Yeah, I mean, you know, like I said, you know, Kovalev is a hell of a puncher, man, and, you know, you got to take that risk. You know, Ward has to take a risk to get in there, you know, and make it a rough fight with him, and I think he's willing to take that risk, like I said, man, you know. And, you know, he has the mentality of a fighter. You know, the guy went down, he got back up, took him around, he gathered himself and fought back harder, you know, so he has the heart of a champion, man.
So you think we might actually get a better fight than the first fight?
Definitely, I think there's going to be a better fight, you know, because each guy knows what each is bringing to the table. It's just all about who makes the adjustment. You know, like I said, Kovalev, he seems like he's definitely coming to fight this time. You know, he had a lot of excuses about overtraining and whatever. You know, and Ward is like, and mentally, he seems like he's coming to fight too. So I think it's going to be a better fight than the first one.
Now, you never want to lose a fight, obviously. But when you're a competitor, a professional athlete, and it gets personal beyond just the athletic competition like this has, how does that add something extra? Does it make you not want to lose that much more? Do you got to tune it out?
I mean, definitely. I mean, you know, but you kind of got to stay grounded. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, when you're competitive, like, I'm probably one of the most, if not the most competitive person in here, just in every aspect of everything, you know, in this gym, you know. And when you're a competitor, man, you know, it just, certain things, you know, can bring certain things out of you. And these guys are, you know, true competitors. But I think Andre Ward is the more competitive. Like, he just seems like he just has that competitive nature about him. He wants to be the best in everything, you know, and that's what it seems like to me, you know, from on the outside looking in. And, you know, I think that these guys genuinely just don't like each other, you know, but, and I think that's going to make for a hell of a fight.
Yeah, I forgot. Thank you for your time, Kevin. Thank you so much, man.
No doubt. Anytime.